Well, hello there, Pluckers. I'm solving here again with you. Thanks for joining me for another guitar lesson. This is a number by a band you may not have heard of before called The Tragically Hip. And the number's called Fiddler's Green. Okay, I came across this number by accident. And apparently they're a band from Canada. And they're well thought of in Canada, they're very popular. Anyway, this is a lovely number, so I thought it'd make a very good lesson. Okay, so. For those of you who haven't heard the number before, or the band, I put a link in the description box below the video, which will take you to a video of the song by the band. Okay, and I do recommend you go and have a listen to it. Well worth it. Right, so we'll do. I'm going to play through the intro, a verse, and the middle section. And an outro. There are three verses altogether. But I don't want to bore you to death with my terrible singing, so keep it as short as possible. So here we go then. Sun has gone, yeah. And that's where he will stay. Wind on ever be tearing blue my sailor me. It's black fast as a sun. Shortened version, saving your ears. Right, first of all, let's get to the lesson. Right, I am in E open tuning. Okay, so basically, my guitar is tuned to sound like an E chord, E major. Okay, so the strings are, so we have to slightly, you have to retune three strings. Okay, start from the first string, that's standard. Second string is standard. Third string you have to tune up from G to G sharp. Okay, so that's now G sharp, third string. Though use an electronic tuner for that probably would make it a lot easier. The fourth string has to be retuned to E from D, so you have to tighten it so it goes up to E. Okay, so basically the fourth string now sounds like the top string, first string. Okay, and then the fifth string has to be retuned to B, so it has to go up, tighten up to B, so that now sounds like the second string. And then you've got the sixth string E, which is standard. So you have to retune the third string, the fourth string, and the fifth string, okay? And when you've done that, it should sound like this, which is E major, okay? So there we are, that's the tuning side of it out of the way. So I'll now talk you through the introduction. Right, so the first thing you need to do is put your finger, I'm using my third finger, on the fifth fret of the third string, and I'm playing, strumming it, then I'm moving down to the third fret of the third string, so it's, I'm basically playing the inside four strings really, so it's 5, 4, 3 and 2, okay. Then you put your, put my second finger on the fourth fret of the fourth string, and then hitting that along with some other notes if you can get them in, and then sliding it down to the second fret of the fourth string. So, and then playing, taking it off and playing it open, okay? So it's, so you, so is that, and then hit the bass note, the sixth string, okay, so it's, okay, and then a bit of a strum, very slow strum, very sort of a somber strum, if you like, I don't know, so let's do that again. Then you play a little fill-in, which is a, so I've got that, so it's hammer onto the second fret of the fifth string, open fourth, back to the second fret of the fifth string, pull off into the fifth open, the sixth string, it's E string, okay? So hammer on, second fret, fifth string, open fourth string, then pull off the second fret of the fifth string to open A, or open, it's not an A, it's a B now, and then sixth string, then strum. So that beginning is, get the hammer, just the hammer, that's all we need on that, is that's all we need, sorry, we don't need to pull off on that bit, so it's just hammer onto the fifth string on the second fret, open fourth, sixth string open, strum, sorry I mislaid you there, so we start that again, right, so the first bit was right, forget the pull off bit, okay, right, and then the second time it's a hammer up from the third fret of the third string to the fifth fret of the third string, so whilst you're strumming, and then back down to the third fret of the third string, and then repeat the that bit, slide from the fourth fret of the fourth string down to the second to open to the sixth string. Oh, sorry, no, it doesn't. Again, I've got you. So this time it's slightly different. So you've got the open bit, but don't hit the E string. Go into that chord. So that's, don't hit the sixth string, okay? The bass string. Okay, try and mute that with your thumb if you just rest your thumb on it. If you think you're going to hit it. Now that chord is a second fret of the fifth string and the first fret of the third string, and the rest of them are open. Okay, so from the beginning it's, mm-hmm. with that little fill in again. And then. Got that? So let's do that again. Does that, and then it repeats on that chord, and it goes back to the open chord, and then it hammers, does the hammer bit again onto the 5th, 2nd fret, 5th string, open 4th, and then it goes into a new chord, which is basically 3rd fret of the 3rd string. Third fret of the fifth string, second fret of the second string, and first fret of the third string. So that's diagonal, really. And then the rest of them are open. Apart from the sixth string, try and mute that one again. Don't want the sixth string in it. Okay, so let's just go from the beginning again. Another one of those little hammer-ons. So you hammer on, so you play the chord, and then you hammer on the 4th string to the 2nd fret, and then play the 1st fret of the 3rd string, so, and then do it again, but this time pull off the 2nd fret to open on the 4th string, and then hit the 3rd fret of the 5th string, and then back to the open bottom string, open chord. Okay, so let's do that again. So when you go into this chord, so right from the beginning, right? So do that one again. The riff on that bit is slightly different. That's a bit the same, but you hit another D note, and then you do the pull off on the 2nd fret to open on the 5th string, 6th string. Okay, that's at the end of the verse, really. Okay, or the intro as well. Okay, so. This is a bit complicated. So here we go again. Let's do this one again from the start. This is just the intro, but mind you, this is mostly the verse as well. Okay, so here we go. Thank you. that's the intro. And then it comes in with the singing, and basically it follows the same part as the intro to start with. September 17. Sun is gonna open. Yeah. And that's where he will. Now, a new chord coming up. Stay. So that's second fret of the fourth string and third fret of the third string. And I'm playing basically the inside strings again. That's 5, 4, 3, and 2. And then there's a bit of a little lick. So second fret of the second string, hit that and pull it off to open, and then hit the open third string, and then back to the chord. So after it goes into that chord, okay, got that? Right, so go from the beginning of the actual verse. So, as number 17, for a girl I know it's Mother's Day. The sun has gone early open, and that's where he will, new chord, stay. Fill in. Then that riff again. Wind on a river bay. Turning blue, I see the moon. As Flagstaff sings a song, opens to a refrain. A little bit of a fill in there, as usual, and then it goes into this chord. For a boy in fiddler's green. Then harmonic on the 12th fret. If you want to do that, just rest your fingers lightly across the 12th fret. Okay, that's what we can do that. So that's it, that's the whole verse, thankfully. So we'll just go through the whole verse once more time, okay? So here we go. Number 17. We all know it's Mother's Day. Sun has gone early. Yeah. That's where he will stay. Tearing blue eyes, see the moon. As Flagstaff sings a sorrowful refrain. For a boy in fiddler's green. Right, now the middle section. There's only about three lines in it. It's so after it comes out of a verse, the second verse, after it comes out the second verse, it just, right, goes into this shape chord, and then goes to that shape. Nothing's changed any. Back to the first one. Nothing's changed any. Okay, so basically the middle section is nothing's changed anyway, nothing's changed anyway, any time today. It's just that shape, up to this shape, nothing's changed any, back to that shape. It's backwards and forwards.
Anyway, nothing's changed anyway. Yeah, yeah, nothing's changed today.
Okay, and the very ending, after he comes out of the third verse, goes backwards into the, it comes out of the third verse and goes into, does a little, that little fill in, second fret, hammer, fifth fret, fifth string, second fret, fifth string, open fourth string, and then into this shape, the diagonal shape. Back to the open, little riff, just backwards and forwards, so those two, with a little fill in there. And that's how I ended it, okay. So same as usual, but you put another fourth string, and then pull off second fret, to open on fifth string, sixth string, then the harmonics. Okay? Well, I hope that makes sense. Thanks for watching and listening, and see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.